Hallelujah. Powerful packed woman of God. Praise the Lord. Come on, let's give God some praise. Come on, let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. I need the Sanctuary
The sanctuary is open daily at noon for prayer. We would like to thank all those who have heeded the call to prayer during the day and night prayer watches, and we have wonderful moves of God operating with the miraculous. And also, we all want you guys to come join us during the prayer watches also. You guys are welcome. Our website is officially up. You can check us out on www.bishoprickybarnett.org. Watch our Sunday service live on Sword of the Spirit television and the Ustream TV. You can type that in the box. Follow us on Facebook, Sword of the Spirit Power Ministries also. Continue to lift up those members that are under the weather, and we believe for God's healing and wholeness. If you have any written prayer requests, please place them in the box in the back for prayer and to sensory temple will pray over them for you guys' needs. We all stand in the need of testimonies for our website of what God has done for you and your family. Please write them down and then hand them to any one of the ministerial staff. For all our guests, children's church is held in the kitchen during the main worship services. It's in the kitchen back. Every Sunday, we are live streaming our worship Sunday schedule. Please turn off all your cell phone ringers. Invite friends, family, co-workers, neighbors to church. All messages are available on the CD for $10 after service. So that resumes our announcements for today.
Apostle, did you need to say anything? Okay, we'll go forth in the service. We're going to have Autumn to come with her solo. Oh, the praise team. Hallelujah. The praise team will come. Amen.
Thank you.
give the Lord a hand of praise. Hallelujah. How great is our God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. We're going to have a praise dance by our own Sister Joanne.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
With the wonder of his time.
Hallelujah. You don't know the cost of the oil in my alabaster box. You don't know the cost of my tears. You don't know the cost of my pain. Hallelujah. Woo, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, sister, for that. That was just awesome. Give her another hand praise. Amen. That was awesome, Joanne. Now we're going to prepare for the word of God. Amen. Stand to your feet and welcome my sister, Minister Leandra King, coming before us for her first time unto the Lord. Amen.
In a dream, because I was concerned about my father and what the doctors had to say. But that was my first mistake, was waiting for what they had to say instead of trusting to believe what God had to say first. And that was my first mistake. But you know, God, when we're going through different seasons, he's showing us our mistakes as we go along the way. But that's where his grace and his mercy comes in for us. Thank God for that. Because there's so many things that we do, even as Christians, and we know the world is constantly watching us. They got it under a scope, and they're watching everything that we do. So anything that does not line up with the word of God, then they're quick to point it out to us and say, you said this, and you said that. And I'm like, yes, you're right. Lord, thank you for your grace. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the deliverance. You know, but you just said it. Yeah, Lord, thank you for the deliverance. It's that fast. That's how much grace and mercy he has upon us, that he can still use us, because we know that the word of God says he loves to use, you know, the foolish things to shame the wise. So you didn't see this one coming. If I go back home in Kentucky, my family's like, you know, Lee, you know, she's in California, she's tripping, and every time she's calling here, she's talking about God this and God that. And I remember when Lee used to sneak into the drive-in. I remember when Lee used to go over there with Jesse and Noopy and steal candy bars. I remember when Lee, and then there was the other side of the family, like, well, that's just Lee. You know what I mean? They entitle you these different things.
Amen.
But thank God for his grace and his mercy. Well, Lord Jesus, I just thank you, Lord. I thank you for this opportunity, Lord Jesus. I thank you for your grace and your mercy that you have upon me, Lord Jesus. I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you've designed me for a day such as this, God. I thank you, Lord. I thank you that everything be acceptable unto you, Lord Jesus. I just honor you and praise you at all time. In Jesus' name I pray. I love history as well. There's something I found that's so interesting regarding a tribe down in Africa. In Africa, there's the Matabu coup, and they believe that the only way to end grief is to save a life. If someone is murdered, a year of mourning ends with a ritual called the drowning man syndrome. It's an all-night party beside the river, and down the killer is put into a boat, and he's taken out to the water, and he's dropped in. This is quite harsh. He's bound so he can't swim. The family of the dead has to make a choice to either let him drown or run and save him. The coup believe if the family lets the killer drown, they will have justice, but they will spend the rest of their lives in mourning. But if they save him, then they admit that life isn't always just. That very act can take away their sorrows, and vengeance is a lazy man's grief. Now, Lord, we just thank you for your grace We thank you for your mercy, and we thank you that we don't live in the tribe of the coup. You know, I was looking through the Bible, and when I was trying to prepare my notes and everything, and I was looking under in the King James Version, how many references in the Bible that is shown here in the Bible regarding grace, and there's over 24 scriptures found under grace. But we know there's more, you know, when you start doing your search and everything like that. But I just need a few. You know, I don't need all of them. I just need a few. So turn to me page into Acts 4 and 3. It says here in Acts, it says, and with the great power, the apostles gave witness to the resurrection of Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. And then turn next to me into James 4. We're going to read 1 through 6. It says in here, where do wars and fights come from among you? Do not come from your desires for pleasures that war is in your members. You lust and do not have, for murder and covet and cannot obtain. You fight and war, yet you do not have because you do not ask. You ask and do not receive because you ask amiss. And you may spend it in your pleasures. Adulterers and adulteresses, do you not know the friendship with the world is enmity with God? Whoever therefore wants to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God. Or do not think that the scriptures say in vain, the scripture who dwells in this yearns jealousy, but he gives more grace. Therefore, he says, God resists the proud before he gives grace to the humble. So, just God just, again, just showing like all of his grace and his mercy that he has upon us and in our ways as we walk with him. It just leaves me in such an awe when we just think of the goodness and the grace that God has given us in all of our ways. You know, I just think, like, during this time, you know, when we were going through David Taylor and going through all the different messages that he was giving us, and, you know, he was showing us, everything that God has for us, you know, in even a different way, the way we kind of always had thought in the traditional aspect. And then I love that he was able to bless us with that. And to give us during this time, because we're tired of the old way, of the way like some of the ministries have given us the word of God as they see it sometimes, but instead of checking with God to see what he says, you know, during this time. And with my walk, I know that was one of my cries that I cried out to him, and like, God, I just want you. I don't want man. I don't want to know how they did it. I don't know how they ran their church, God, but I just want to know how you want me to be edifying to you and your word so that you can use me, God. Use me. But when you start asking and start asking for those kind of requests, there's a cost to it. And there's an attack that sometimes that comes along with it. So when you say, yes, Lord, it is me, Lord, use me, God, be ready. And I'm telling you right now, be ready. In season, out of season, night seasons, I mean, be ready. And in this short amount of time, when we accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, and then when you start getting closer to him and trying to get into the ministry, the attacks become greater. Yeah, y'all know what I'm talking about? Like, he starts coming after you more. He started coming after me, even in my finances. I was like, Lord, this past week, my car got taken away. And I was like, God, I'm going to give it to you. 1 Peter 5:7 says, cast all my burdens upon you. So God, I don't know how I'm going to get that car out. And then he said, well, that's your first mistake again. You said, how am I going to get that car out? He says, how are you going to cast it on me and then ask for it, how you want to get it back? I'm like, Lord, I'm sorry. You know, I don't know if the Holy Spirit convicts y'all, because I get convicted left and right up inside. I'm like, Lord, okay. I'm trusting and believing you, God. Put it on their hearts, God. Because I can't, every direction I'm going in, I can't go to any direction. You know, so like when the bill collectors call, they say, well, can't you ask a family member? Really? No. And I said, I actually told a bill collector one time, I said, would you do me a favor? Would you pray with me? Because I'm trusting and believing God that he's going to pay this bill. Yeah. They have a phone, they begin to pray with me. And praise God. Anywho, my testimony is this, that when God showed up, he showed out. Not only did he give me the car back, but he put a little bit extra in my pocket. I'm like, Lord, thank you. That is you, God. There's nobody but you. I didn't have to do anything but just keep praising to him during that season and keep trusting to him during that season and then keep just walking by faith and not by sight, because in the natural, I'm telling you, I don't know about y'all, but there wasn't nothing there. I mean, I could dig my pockets in and out. There wasn't anything but there but lint. So, but I said, God, I thank you, Lord. So I went on my Facebook and I started posting pictures of checks. I put a $10,000 check out there. I put a $6,000 check. I put every picture I could find with money on it. And I claimed, I said, Lord. And then my family started calling and they said, you got some money? And I said, I sure do. Right? Because that's that faith. Like, they believed it and I believe it. So, Lord Jesus, I just thank you. Thank you, Jesus, that we are your creatures, that we can walk by faith and not by sight in the natural, because in the natural, things don't look so good. In the natural, jobs are still looking funny, and money's funny, and change is strange, and all those kind of old cliche sayings. I don't know. You got to stop saying it. Money is an abundance. Money comes to me. Lord, send the morning angels out and send forth what is mine, Lord Jesus. Adam may have given away, but by you, Lord Jesus, and we redeemed it all. So we got to go back and start taking back what the devil stole. My time, my job, my finances, all of it, my children, my husband. How about that? Right? It's all mine. It's all here. What's not going to happen is God's not going to bring down bars of gold. He's put everything already here. We just have to go after it. Go after it and name it and claim it in the name of Jesus. It is mine. He gave it to me. I never met a Caucasian kid that, when they get an inheritance, ever start wondering, you know, when can I get it or when can I get it? They just go and then they spin and they go to the Alpine Mountains and they go skiing and they just have a good time. They don't ever look back about their inheritance. So why should I start wondering, like, well, God, I know. You gave the snow. You gave the mountains, Lord, and it's all mine. So I'm claiming it all. Every last bit of it is all mine. Thank you, Jesus. So we know that the world has sympathy, and they may even have empathy and feel for you. But a real Christian has compassion, and they act on it. So, Lord, I just thank you for my brothers and sisters in Christ, as we've been warring in the spirit for our sister Wanda during this week, and when just praying and lifting and believing in you, God, that we've been acting as real Christians and reaching out to our fellow brothers and sisters and going, Lord Jesus, and going to the hospital rooms and praying and coming before the throne of God, because we believe by faith she is healed. She will be in the service soon. I know for a fact she will be here. I heard what the doctor said, but I know what God said. Whose report are we going to believe? It is you, God. It is you, God. We have to start digging into her more, believing. Just a child, if I told a child to come up here right now, and even if they saw different things here on the ground, they're still going to come because they trust and believe in me. They're just going to go without any hesitation. So we just want to have a mind of like a child, that we can just believe, God. I just believe you, God. You're going to just take care of every last bit of it. So I honor you and I praise you, Lord Jesus, and I hope that everything I said is edifying to you and your word and acceptable unto you, God. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Get ready. another hand praise. Amen. That was her very first time. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And there's more to come. Amen. There's more to come. We're going to welcome, stand to your feet and welcome Minister Isabel Kavanaugh, my sister on fire.
Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit, for allowing me to be here this morning. I would like to honor my spiritual father, Dr. Ricky L. Barnett, First Lady. I would like to honor everyone of my sisters that are giving the word with me today. Amen. There is an honor for me to be here with you, sister, Sister Deanna. And I would like to honor all the ministers in the house of the Lord. My husband that has been there for me and tried to help me out through this time, and to my children that are watching me through U.S. Stream, and my family in New Orleans and Honduras. Before anything, I thank you, Father God. I thank you, Father God, for this is your day. This is the day that you have made, Father God. You have bring me, Father God, and you brought me through, Father God, through it all. I thank you, Father God. I thank you, Father. Let it not be me, Father God. Let it not be my mouth speaking, but you speaking through me, Father God. Use me, Father God. I humble myself before you, Father God, and your throne, and I thank you, Father God. I come with thanksgiving, Father God, to your throne. And I pray, Father God, that you touch everyone, Father God, right now, Father God, they're going to hear your word, Father God, through me, Father God. I pray, Father God, that you touch our hearts, Father God, our minds, our bodies, our souls, our spirit, Father God. And anything that is not of you, Father God, I rebuke it right now in Yeshua's name, and I command it to loose in Jesus' mighty name. Not my will be done, but your will be done, Father God, that your name will be glorified, Father God. In Yeshua's name, thank you, Father God. Amen. So, and let's go. We're going to go to that Gospel of John, chapter 12. And we're going to go to 12:1, verse 1-3. And with the saints that are ready, and say amen. 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 Then Jesus, 6 days before the Passover, came to Bethany, where Lazarus was, who had been dead, whom he raised from the dead. There they made him a supper, and Martha served. But Lazarus was one of them that sat at the table with him. Then took Mary a pound of ointment of spikenard, very costly, and anointed the feet of Jesus, and wiped his feet with her hair, and the house was filled with the odor of the ointment. If we see it right now in this chapter, Jesus was getting ready to be crucified. He was talking to the disciples already, telling them that in 3 days he was gonna build the temple in 3 days. These disciples were already hearing about his crucifixion. But none of them came and say, how can I bless you? How can I thank you for what you have done? How can I worship you and be grateful? None of them. But yes, Mary, a sinful woman. The Bible talks about her. She was a prostitute. She was a sinner. Just like me and everyone here. That God took us out of that pit But she brought, the Bible talks that she brought that box, a box with the anointing oil, with a perfume that it cost 300 denarii. If you look in the Bible, if you read 4, it will tell. And also in Matthew 26, and also in the book of Luke, it speaks about Mary, about what she did. She came with this perfume that is so expensive, 300 denarii, which is a salary for a person of a year. Everything, I believe everything she had, she brought it and she poured it out at the feet of the Lord Jesus. I believe that each one of us had an oil inside us that Jesus is waiting for us to come and make our way to Him and pour it out at His feet. I believe that Jesus, a miracle Jesus that has worked in our life, is waiting for us to pour out our way, to break our hearts, our feet, and tell Him how much we are grateful, how much we thank Him, how much we love Him for what He has done for us, for where He brought us out. He brought me out of witchcraft. He brought me out of my house where my husband almost killed me. He brought me out of jail. I went to jail. Yes, I did. And I thank God for that, because through that He used me. Through that, I could use that oil that was already in me. And not just that, but the Bible also talks that that house is smell. It was the odor of that perfume. How many know that when we walk, that perfume of Jesus is in us? That when we walk, if we go to jail, that perfume that is in us is spoke about Jesus. We don't need to not even say anything when the people come to us. Why? Because that's the aroma of Jesus is in us. I thank God for that. I thank God for what I went through. I thank God that not just Mary, that sinner Mary, had to come and break that box and that perfume on His feet. I've been asking that, Lord, break me, Lord. Break me, Lord. This is my time to be broken, Father. I don't want to be prideful anymore. I don't want to be, Father God, a bitter woman, Father God, for all what I took from my ex-husband, Father God. I don't want to be, Father God, that woman, Father God, that it was a jealous woman, Father God. I want to be that woman of God. I want to be that woman of God that has the oil that put out pureness, which is Jesus Christ. I thank God for that. And in the name of Jesus, I ask one thing of this. She said she went with 300 denarii, the Bible says. If you come down on verse 6, it says, Lazarus, he commended, the disciples criticized her for the action of love, for the action of gratitude. How many people criticize us when we come to church and say, why you go to church? Why you go to that apostle? Why you go see that prophet? Why? But yes, Jesus, the mighty Jesus was sitting there, not asking for nothing, because He never asked for nothing. It says Lazarus was there, and he was in the house of the leper. That means He already made a miracle of healing a leper. He already made a miracle to lifting up and bringing back from death Lazarus. So Jesus sitting there, the disciples and Lazarus start saying, why this money was not given to the poor? Why did He say that? Because He was the keeper of the money, and He already took that money. He already stole that money. So I ask this question, and I apologize if I come out a little rude, but how many of us take from the bag of the tithes? How many of us don't give the offering that belongs to the Lord? How many of us, instead of saying, this is not mine, this is His, and we take it back home, or I need to pay the car, or I need to pay my rent? I say this because I did it in the past, and I had to learn my lesson. How many of us, instead of saying, you know what, I'm going to give this extra offering, you know the Bible says as we give, it gives back to us. And double of the measure. Amen. So, at the same criticize this woman's action. He went with the Pharisees, and he sold our Lord for 30 coins of silver. And which group are we? Are we in the group that give everything we have for the Lord? Or are we in the group that we sell our Lord and take away what is his? I just thank God. I just thank God this morning. And I thank you, Apostle, for being my spiritual daddy. When I came that morning and I asked the Lord, you were with me. And I thank you for the way you're being and bringing me out. I thank you because this is my first time I speak. And I thank God that he gave me this word. I thank God for everything. And this is my conclusion. Jesus is worth it. It's worth it. He gave us life and eternal life. He didn't go to the cross. And he didn't resurrect at the third day. And sitting at the right side of the Father. Just for sitting. It was for a purpose. Amen. To give us eternal life. Amen. It's worth it. Amen. In the name of Jesus, thank you. Thank you.
Hallelujah. Give her a hand praise. Amen. For her first time, she was on fire. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. She's one of the ones that's at this altar. Amen. Gotta pull that stuff out. You get to the altar, amen? Amen. That was awesome. Now we're gonna have my sister Tawana, our warrior princess in dance, amen. She's gonna do a praise dance unto the Lord for us. Hallelujah.
Don't leave it. Come on, no boundaries.
you heard. So you can see what you said. Say what you heard. So you can see what you said. Oh, pray these words. Take the limits off. 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 Take the limits off.
Every, como naki, Amen. Acknowledgement to God the Father, Son, and the Holy Ghost, in whose presence that I stand, in whose presence that you sit to deliver this word I honor, give every ounce of fiber of my very being, to Apostle and First Lady I honor, to the leaders and those of you who are here that I don't know, and you are in positions of leadership within the fivefold and beyond. You know who you are, and I honor you. To all of you in the body of Christ, I honor you this morning. More importantly, my sisters that came before me, I honor God in them and the word that they shared, speaking from their very personal experience of what God is doing, has done, and will continue to do through them. There's great work in them, great ministry, great call, and I thank God that he's birthing them right here on this pulpit for greatness. Amen. Amen. Also want to, before I forget, I just want to honor the women of power. Those of you who don't know, it's been a strenuous, and also to the membership of this house, it's been a strenuous past month or so. We had a wonderful, awesome event, a great man of God, and if the acknowledgments weren't given, I'm standing before you on behalf of God the Father to say thank you. And to acknowledge every one of you, whether you served physically, face to face, in front, so people can see you, or behind the scenes, you are honored today. And thank you for your work and your servitude. And know that your labor is not in vain, because God sees all. And he knows all. Mm-hmm. And in due time, may not come today or next week, but he will honor you, be it privately or publicly. But the challenge is that you continue to serve him with a heart of a servant and give him everything that you got. Even if you got nothing left, just give. And God will honor you. And you will see in due season. My message is going to be brief. I'm going to hit this thing quick so that we can keep it pushing. Amen? Amen. Genesis 19, verse 26. Let's go. First book in the Bible. Chronologically, so forth to speak. First book in the Bible. Let's go. Genesis 19, verse 26. I'm reading out the King James, so let me know if you guys are there. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. If you wanted to title this message, the title will be Walk and Don't Look Back. Walk and don't look back. Are we there? Genesis 19, verse 26. But his wife looked back from behind him, and she became a pillar of salt. There is a ancient mystic Chinese philosopher named Lao Tzu. And I know some of you are familiar with the saying. He said, the journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. Those of you not familiar with Genesis chapter 19, the Lord has sent two angels to go forth and send a, so to speak, a search and rescue mission. Lot and his family. Sodom, Canaanite city, evil, and her twin city was Gomorrah. And Sodom, if you were to translate her name, means burning. And Gomorrah means submersion. Both of these cities are located within the area of the Dead Sea and the Jordan River. And both of these cities were scheduled, and it came to pass. If we know, those of you that know the story, were destroyed by fire from heaven because of their iniquity and their moral wickedness. So the angels are sent forth with the word to Lot. And you see the filthiness of human nature. It's amazing that we can get that level, and it's already here in society today all over the world, of this uttermost disgust, straight abomination to God Almighty Himself, of the desire and the selfishness, how dare we, that we misuse this flesh in our for the use other than what He created us to become. Man and woman. And here, Sodom and Gomorrah, my God, in their moral wickedness, have the audacity. And you see, they watch people coming in and out. I'm going to paraphrase this thing. Y'all can read on. People that come in and out of the gates. And it's apparent that they notice the two angels. They didn't know them as angels, but as men. And come banging on the door, Lot's door. We want them. Come. And so the conversation is back and forth, and he tries his best to defend his gifts and offers up his own daughter. Who have yet to sleep with men, I'm being honest, according to the word. In the midst of this exchange and the intenseness of the conversation, you know, they're trying to barge their way to this house, the angels pull them back. And the word goes forth, instruction. Get out. Escape with your life. Verse 17. And it came to pass when they brought them forth abroad, and he said, escape for thy life. Look not behind thee. Neither stay thou in all the plain. Escape to the mountain, lest thou be consumed. Prior to that, the angel said, look, get your family together. And whoever else that you know, get them together and go. The word goes, he approaches his son-in-laws, and they mock him. Okay, well, you don't want to go. As they're getting ready to escape and go out, Lot comes and has a conversation with one of the angels. Well, you know, if I were to go to the mountain and to the plain, you know, I don't know if we'll make it and I might die over there. How about if I just go, you know, to go R? So R means insignificant. That was one of the five cities that was slain for destruction by God. But he spared that city because of Lot. We've entered into 2013. Walked into this new year, the 27th day of the first month of 2013. How has your new year been up until this 27th? Did it start off rough? Has it been struggles? Or did it start off relatively happy and optimistic, but then something just kind of came along the way and put a dent in your journey? I had unexpected news on the 8th day of this month. Personal tragedy in my family. And I buried my aunt. She committed suicide, unbeknownst to us. And that troubled and vexed me very deeply because she was one in our whole family. And when I talk about my family, I'm not talking about nuclear family or extended. I'm talking clan. I come from a culture, we have hierarchy in my culture. I come from chiefs and talking chiefs, and there's royalty. I come from that kind of a society. And so she was the auntie in my family, my clan. Out of my grandmother's side, if I was to trace it, I am the eighth generation. So our great-greats were sisters. She comes from one line and I come from one. But she was the one, out of all of our extended family, she made sure that she visited every last one of us, every year. Grew flowers, had fruit trees, and would always bring flowers to the house for my grandma. Always bring fruits. And so the news comes. I'm already walking in this new year. Here comes the news. The Lord said, will you continue to walk before me? Because of this. Yes, Lord. Will you continue, as I said to Abraham, walk through the land? Yes, Lord. Will you continue to walk after me and not contrary to me? Will you continue to walk in my statutes, in my commandments, in my word, with me? Yes, Lord. Isaiah 43:18 says, remember not the former things, but consider things that have yet to come. Philippians 3:13, I am bringing all my energies into this one thing, forgetting the past and looking forward to what lies ahead. Amen. Life is such that we must encounter death, ones that are close to us, encounter the highs and the lows. And yet the challenge is, will you continue to walk and not look back? You see, the problem with Lot's wife was she was reluctant to walk home. Her longing was for what was back there. This is what I'm familiar with. This is what I like. This is where I found my comfort zone. This is where everything makes sense. This is what I understand and know. Because what lies before me is unknown. Jesus said, I am the light of the world. He that shall not walk in darkness, but he shall have the light of life. He also said, if any man must come after me, he must first deny himself, pick up his cross, and follow me. I'm not saying deny what happened yesterday. I'm not saying that yesterday isn't a reality. What I'm saying, despite what yesterday said and what happened yesterday, continue to walk and not look back. Her issue was everything that she loved and owned was in the city of burning and submerging, of moral wickedness and sin. Now pick and turn me down. world, you will have tribulation. But be of good cheer. Because I have overcome the world. I had to stand and watch and hear my extended family talking and bickering, some complain and wail and cry. And in my quietness, in my silence, pray. We don't know what 2013 holds. But my God, we know who holds 2013. Amen. Where are you on this 27th day of January in your walk with the Lord? Has life's struggles and pressure held you back from pursuing the creative of you? It we do not want to be in a position like Lot's wife and be disobedient. My God. Then when instruction goes forth into our lives, that we think we are better than God, or we know better than him. Partial disobedience is still disobedience.
Amen.
Amen.
She disobeyed that instruction. And the word says she was behind Lot, following and turning and turning to fulfill herself. We follow the creator of the universe. If he says, stop it, stop. If he says, go, go. If he says, don't look back, guess what? Don't look back. Your disobedience. She didn't know she was going to die instantly, and let alone be transformed into a pillar of salt. My God, imagine that. As a, she serves as a reminder to us today. Instruction from God is critical. Your obedience to his instruction is critical to your own personal life. He says, I will instruct you. I will teach you in the way that you should go. And my counsel will go with you. My eye watches. The word and the challenge from this day forth till December 31st of 2013 is to walk ahead and not look back. Amen. My God, I thank you. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hey, God, I thank you. Woo, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, God, I thank you. God, I thank you. I'm done. Give me some music, Reggie. Here's the call. Any one of you. It needs to get their life right in Christ. This is the place. If you want to accept Christ as your personal Lord and Savior, this is the place. pray. If you need prayer, my God, I'll give you prayer. They're here. Ministers are here to pray with you and for you. If you need me to pray for you, you need to seek God about 2013, about walking this year with Him. You're not sure. Come. Oh, God, I thank you. I thank you. Hallelujah. Hey, thank you. Hallelujah. Come. Come, my God, I thank you. Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Hey, God, I thank you. Ooh.
God, you need prayer, come. Oh, God, you need prayer, come.
We worship you. Come on, come on, come on.
Man does not qualify you or say that you can or cannot. It is God. Can I come up on you?
out of the wages of the White House. I see Washington, D.C. I see that show. It is that kind of a level, that kind of place, that kind of standard. Globally, at that level.
In the name of Jesus. You think his brother, Joshua?
Nah.
too much of this. He's the one that it's not even taking me here. I know I'm so near, but it's still working. I just see. It's like it brings a balance. Makes sense to you. Wants to make sure mom is not overtly in this. You know. Instead of mom taking care of baby, baby taking care of mom. Yes. He knows who you are. He knows who he is. He's a son for you. This is the one that's going to stick with you for the rest of your life, right? Won't go far. He will be my friend, but always come back to me. Because of this connection that I'm born with you. God gives my God and bless you. He knew you were the go for. So he placed those cups. And I come on. God, give it up.
Thank you.
God, yeah. He gonna restore. Infuse your spirit within you with the spirit of obedience. God, I thank you. Whew. God, I thank you. Here's what you need to do. Every time before you go to bed at night and wake up in the morning, you get ready. You need to get on your knees and pray and ask the Lord to help you. You understand? Can you do that? And see what, how your day goes. With prayer and without prayer. He's the only one that. Not on the set. It's like, God, I Yes, 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 Lord. Yes, yes, yes. Don't doubt. Don't doubt. Don't doubt. Do not doubt. Do not doubt. That's your hindrance. Do not doubt. Do not doubt God's word. Don't doubt his promise. Do not doubt. Oh, God. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. In the name of Jesus. 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 Ooh. Release that. Release that thing. Take it off. Still carrying that burden. Take it off. Just wait. Hallelujah. I knew I recognized you. Hey. Woo! I'm on it. Oh, in the words of John the Baptist, even I am not. You are generally known, right? People don't know that. Because of what you've labored and been through. Years past. Eka! Rush you. Sorry, everybody. But you know what, prophetess? It shaped you into the vessel that you have become today. You have so many spiritual children. revert, we recycle. We recycle the gift. Pass on to the next, to the next. And you don't want to do it. Come on, my God. Woo! The ministry that God has for you is huge. It's a global scale. I didn't see Africa. I didn't see Asia. Even the Americas. In Europe. What I said, you're going to hit every one of those continents. The invitations are coming. Very hot. Russia, Delta. Call me up. You get ready. Get up, come on. My God, this is what you've been waiting for. Woo! God, I bless you. Yeah, God. God, I thank you. Ooh, release, God. Release. Hey, God, thank you. Head I come. Woo! Release, God. Head I open. Head I march. Woo! Hey, yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, yes, yes. Woo! Yes, God. And we bless her, God. In the name of Jesus, Lord.
Deep sleep tonight. Deep rest, Father. Renewing of their strength in the soul, body, and spirit. Father, give them visions and dreams of their future and their purpose tonight. Release angels to encamp around them tonight. In Jesus' name, in Yeshua's name, we pray. The church say amen, amen, amen. Give the Lord a hand. Amen. We're going to take an offering. I'm going to say a few things. I know we didn't have class Tuesday night. Make sure you're here this Tuesday night. I'm in town. We just came back from Arizona. I'm home in Arizona yesterday. And we was with David Taylor and Michelle Corral last night. Amen. A great meeting with Mother Nicholas, the spiritual mother of Juanita Bynum. And then we was up there and we gleaned from Michelle Corral's mother and all those by Catherine Kuhlman. It was truly a blessing to be in the midst of those great anointed people last night. God is given to do something great in this ministry. He showed me dreams last week about a revival out of this house. Showed me then with REM to the people. I got a call while I was in Arizona from David Andretti, the gentleman who put the stadium events together around the world. He want to meet with me tomorrow. Amen. Please give him a hand praise. Amen. He's here in Washington, D.C. Also, Michelle Burrell said, told me last night that when they bring David Taylor back, he wants us to be part of bringing, along with their ministry, bringing him back. So he said, let's give the Lord a hand. this ministry, and I want to commend it was prayer who did this, and I commend all the willing women and the men that was coming to pray here. We'll open up a vortex in the spirit for God to bless this ministry and those who are part of this ministry. A lot of people say this ministry wouldn't last, the things I was doing, you know, trying to raise up other ministers, and I got criticized about that, but God knew what his plan. I obeyed what the Spirit of the Lord gave me to do to raise his people up, and we will continue to raise up his people. He might want me to change some things. I'm praying about some things we change to go forth with the vision he showed me. It's time for us to go up. Time for us to expand. It's time for us to increase. So some changes might happen, which is led by the Spirit, and I'm praying on it. But it'll be all for the good, for the vision he's given us. We will be international. Amen.
Amen.
I'm my spiritual son, entrepreneur from Liberia. Amen. I'm trying to plan for me to come the same time to Liberia. That the whole crusade with David Taylor being there. So a lot of things happen behind the scene. And it will take prayer, and it will take finances to do what God wants. And once you start obeying God in your finances, you're going to start seeing your blessings come upon you, because there's a blessing upon this house. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen. To feel what God gave this house to do. Amen? Amen. So we're just praising and magnifying him and give him all the glory. Give the Lord a hand, praise. Amen. Amen. And I want to make sure you come out tomorrow night. I don't know what the Lord going to, I mean Tuesday night, I don't know what the Lord going to do. But I know that we'll be able to move in the Spirit. She's on the phone. Okay, just pray in the tongue. I'm trying to talk to you. She's all right. The Holy Ghost dealing with her.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, and we want to pray. We want to increase the time for the expansion. I will be moving to Bellflower next month. Amen.
Amen.
Two more weeks, I should be over here. I already got someone to take over the lease on my house for a year in LA. Amen. I'm going to keep, you know, sick in my house in Arizona, but I'll be going back and forth, but I got an apartment here right between the seats of power, and we'll be bringing someone in here also to, I'm going to train how to take the city, so gentleman I met up there, got a book out on Azusa Street Revival. He wanted to come speak here and teach us the strategy of how to take a city. Also, we probably bring more major speakers in here, since we brought David Taylor. We might be trying to get Earthquake Kelly. Yeah, I heard of him. He said he'll come speak here, so we may be reaching out for him to get him here. He's local, amen. Then we might get Cindy Trim, amen. Come on, somebody. I love my Cindy. I hate to talk about it, but she did a lot with Michelle Corral down there. So we into that group of people now. Amen. Something opened up for us. People are talking about this ministry, especially the man that had the stadium, the stadium events. And what did he tell you? Come tell him what he told you.
He told me he was saying that he been looking for a church like this for 30 years, and he finally found it.
Wow.
30 years. Yes.
You know, it's awesome. I said 30 years, and this is what they do. They travel around to different churches for this revival. And he said this is the first church in 30 years that he actually filled.
Yes, and this guy with the stadium events around the world.
Yeah.
And they want us to be connected to some stadium events that we're doing. They had the Rose Bowl here, and they're going to do some more things. But they're in Washington, D.C. They'll be back tomorrow and have a meeting. So I want the church to get ready, because we're going to the next level. I want spirit of excellence to be upon the house, your appearance, because, you know, we are live streaming and different countries are watching us now. Amen. And I'm ready to start promoting that webcam pretty soon. Amen. We haven't promoted yet. And we went from 333 views in 1 week to close to 1,300 in 1 week. And I think we've been seen in England, Honduras, Fiji Islands. Amen. So once I go to Africa, we have a lot of people from Africa watching us. So we are already going international without promoting. So we want the house to get totally in order. We want everybody to be in place. God can be sending other people here. I know once the word get around about us, he can send other leaders in the house, other talents and gifts in the house. So don't, you know, it's going to happen because once God put your name out, like with his presence, a lot of people start coming here.
Amen.
So I want to promote the people that have been with me at the beginning. I want you to be have an opportunity to, you know, once it, you know, to be seen with your gifts, because you guys stuck through the thick and the thin.
Amen.
I had to think about it. You can't suffer with me, you sure can't reign with me. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
So I just want to thank those, and I thought, I was thinking Reverend Ross today, you know, they've been with me since we started the ministry in the house. We got to get ready to do some major in this ministry. So I want you to start inviting people. I've made my mind up, and I was the reason why I went to growth, because I didn't want to deal. I wanted to leave because I had a home in Arizona, but God changed my whole attitude about Bellflower. He changed my whole concept. He showed me what he wanted me to do here. I'm going to do it. So we're going to be in Bellflower, my wife and I. Give a hand, praise. We've done a lot of traveling. We'll be in Bellflower on foot, networking with the City Hall, the Police Department, also the Chamber of Commerce, and working with the community leaders to get this ministry recognized. And they already know about it, but we're going to do a great work here. It's time. When I came here, I got discouraged with in-house fighting and division, and I didn't want to be part of it. I had time for no mess. And I sure ain't got no time for no mess now. I'll tell you, I'll keep it real with you, I ain't got time for no mess.
Amen.
Amen. So,
amen.
Y'all need to be on the van. That song is said, I'm too blessed to be stressed. Come on, amen. So we want to go forward. I want you, so, you know, Sunday, first Sunday, try to fill the house up. I'm going to be open the door to the church for growth, church growth. People be blessed. Their business is going to expand. You're going to start seeing multiplication in your finances.
Amen.
Also, as you are, I'm praying on it. And you can start seeing people with testimonies about the businesses increasing and entrepreneurs. Also, they're trying to get me back in the music business. And then our mentor had just got a major distribution deal, digital, and they would get some born-again records music on there. And so there'd be opportunity for me to help other people get their music in a digital distribution, so I have the access to that.
Amen.
Through the mentor, Eddie Guerin. Amen. We know he's an R&B, but he also was our solid financial partner in Born Again Records. So I might get back in the record business. Might start a promotional company here to promote radio, get records played, you know, to make income here. Also, Brad gonna be getting his license for counseling. Amen. Counseling here too. Amen. Along with things, this is a very active place. And I expect people from, you know, once God's present in the ministry, people from different places will come and just experience his presence.
Amen.
And I mean, my wife and I will come home, give me a couple of matches here, and I'll be sleeping in here too. You know, at least once a week. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
And so we're going to, I'm only 4 minutes away, so we're really going to, amen, I can sneak up on y'all quick, amen. So I'm very excited. It's time for the church growth, it's time for it to get together, time for expansion. David Taylor said that, you know, that we family now. And he's telling everybody about us, and other guys telling people about us. So we expect to have anybody up in this house now. I can get Mother Nicholas to come preach now. Get Juanita Bounds mentor. She was with us last night. Amen. Amen. She's been in the music business, so Bishop Abney's album in Flint, Michigan, we recorded there with Marvin Sapp and Jennifer Holliday. So we know a lot of people in the music business, and I think Sonya Berry wanted to be involved. She called me. She wanted to get in, see what's happening. But a lot of things are going to happen. So we need to fill these seats up. Amen. I wanted to get other seats. We're going to fill these seats up. I want everybody to be in order. I want all the leaders to be in position. And I want unity in this house.
Amen.
Amen. Lord showed me a revival. But it takes prayer and unity to do it. You hear me? It takes unity to sort of revival. And I used to say, we're going to make church history. We're going to make church history. Because the Lord loved humble places. Everything he had done major was in humble places, not in major fine edifice. He always go to a humble place. Like that man said, he went to Bishop Blake's church, expecting to find the kind of anointing. He went to Catherine Kuhlman's grave. When he walked in this house, come on somebody, that's speaking volumes, that this is what they've been looking for 30 years. So the presence of God is here, is tangible. Amen. You are blessed people, don't know you're blessed. Amen?
Amen.
So I want you to start, reflect that in your giving, in your expectation. We're going to need finances to do what he put in my heart to do. We're going to need finances. We're going to need. And I expect God to release millions of dollars into my hands. The prophecies to come true. The millions, because I want to put people, on payroll, on staff, on payroll. As I told the Lord, I want those who have proven themselves to be trustworthy, also faithful in the ministry. I want, that's what I'm going to ask the Lord for the finances. I just need a couple of $1 million to do that. Because right now we are ranch, a multi-million-dollar corporation. My partner and I, we have 53 employees. And, we was on Wilshire Boulevard. So I've been there and done that. And we want to do it in this house. See, in this house. Let's give the Lord a hand praise. So, Uncle, I want to bless your hands and stand in agreement with you. Here's some music. Would you walk to the Lord? And I want to stand in agreement that you bring your tithes and your liver offering, Father. I'll say in the greeting the next 7 days. Your son shall have a blessing. In the name of Jesus. Oh, share the that's an anointing of my son. Oh, now my kids, they can be born. Where my kids, they can be had a profession. Oh, sir, I will call, they can be a blessing. Now release it. Release. Release the finances. Release the finances. He's faithful. Lord, release the finances. Release the finances, Father. In Jesus' name. Oh, praise him. Oh, praise him. Oh, praise him. Oh, praise him.
Jesus!
Heal him. Say, neighbor, can you? Bless your hands. Bless your finances. Bless your household. Jesus. Oh, yeah. But now I take it. Bless your daughter. Bless her gift. Bless a gift. Bless a gift. Gift. Jesus. Give him a Jonah gift. Thank God. Bless him. Bless him. Father, may you can bless your Father. Bless him, Father. Bless him, Father. Oh, Father, bless him. This is your out the house for the Spirit to expect your blessings. This is the year. Bring divine reversal. And I'll be praying for finances and entrepreneurs this year. I expect for the financial blessing to come, for the people of God to be prospered in this house. This year, if I'm praying in the Spirit, I'm pulling from the Spirit for your blessings, financial blessings. And your hands be blessed. I decree it by faith. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, the Son of the Living God, this year I decree your blessings. I command your blessings to come. From the north, east, south, and west, I command, I don't ask, I command the release, divine reversal this year. That everything the devil took from you, stole from you, shall be returned to you this year. Divine reversal. Praying for finances. Praying for everything. This year, producing everything that you've been praying for. In secret, you shall receive it this year. The Lord is well pleased with you. He's well pleased. He's well pleased with you. It's your heart. It's your heart. I'm praying for your finances because you are a tither. Increase, Father. increase. Increase. Come here, prosperity. I told you I ain't calling you Penny no more. You've been dealing with a whole lot of money, so Penny is nowhere close to what in this. Lord, this year, show your daughter. Show your daughter, Father. This year, show her, Jesus. You guys gonna prosper this year. Everybody goes to get neighbor. The prosperity is coming. Look cute today. Look cute today. Open it up, Father. Bring them, bring them, bring them. Shit, they gonna go sit there. I'm gonna pray that release of power. I'm just praying for the mother. I'm praying for a few healing. Jesus already visited her. John needs somewhere. You tell you? Whatever happens, it's in his hands. It's his will. Shit, it is. You're blessed. Blessed. The child is blessed. The anointing in this house will get stronger and stronger. It's going to get stronger. That's why he made me to lay up on that pulpit. When I lay up on that pulpit, because he had me in the headship, when I lay up on that pulpit all night long, y'all ain't seen nothing yet. Y'all haven't seen what God gonna do in this house. Y'all ain't seen no signs of wonders. But he showed me Jesus. It's released. Your blessing is. Your blessing is. Your blessing. Oh my God. Your blessing. You're a giver. Because of your giving, he gonna do. Entrust you, oh, with so much. You're proving yourself trustworthy. You're proving yourself faithful because of your trustworthiness and your faithfulness and your obedience. You must have an increase in your finances. You must have it. We're going to build this house upon the anointing and the holiness of God. But you're not holding that back, are you? That's empty, huh? But it changed. You know, aren't you blessed? You're a little entrepreneur. This little man is a businessman.
For sure, yeah.
He's going to be really blessed financially. Watch. This kid right here, money going to come to him. He know how to get that financing. He's a businessman. Bless him right now, Father. Bless him, Father. Bless him right now. Bless him right now, Father. Oh, bless him, Father. Bless him, Father. Bless him right now. Jesus. Oh, how do I say it? Oh, now I can't take it. Oh, now I can't take it. We're going to talk about Africa. I talk to you guys, we're going to start planning. I'm trying to have some dates. Hello? You got a secret in Africa? Okay. Okay, so I'm talking to an entrepreneur. I'm planning some things. I'm trying to open some doors for you. They were putting that dance. I love those wings.
I feel your spirit.
So the opportunity to come on this, put your name out there. In these meetings, every group's up and they hit your kid.
Come and fill.
Oh, now I'm sick. And I'm like, oh, shit. And it is. Release it, Father. Release those finances. Release those finances. Release
your presence.
In Jesus' name. Bring them. you release it. She needs increase. I command you to come. I command these finances to come.
Yeah.
Lord, I ask you to give her some listings. Never the money's that in the listings. To listing, Father, I'm asking for three within the next 3 months. It's time for you to be blessed financially. There's gifts up in you that you got to step into. To open up the finances. It's something you don't have to do besides what you're doing. Something you might not want to do, but it can release finances. Lord, I ask you to show her. She was seeing you, see her while she had been. Show her in a dream or vision what you want her to do for finances. Some things that she like to do, that want to do, and she'll be hindered by the lack of the finances, Father. Lord, and now, Lord, I ask you to show her where it's not much work. There's no work involved. It's the gift you have given her, Father. Show her that gift was to prosper. Lord, show, open up that gift and show her in a dream, Father, to prosper your daughter this year. In Jesus' name, amen. This is good. I like the shoes, I like the dress. You look like royalty. I expect this year, the devil meant for evil. You have a divine reversal. I want you to think your right foot is stomped three times on the devil's head. That's it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Watch what God do. Watch what God do. Watch what God do. Watch what God do in your life. This guy is gonna do it. I got my check on it in the back. I give too. Y'all don't know that, but I used to take my money in the back. Y'all thought I don't give, but I was thinking back in the back. I write a check in the back. Amen. So, does anybody else want to give sacrificial offering? Okay. Father, in the name of Jesus, we ask for 100-fold return blessings from the tithes and offerings, Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Be here, on Tuesday night. I'll be back here Tuesday night. School of the Prophets. We have a great time in the Lord. Those who are missing, I want you to help be here Tuesday night. Let me pray for her. This infirmity in the name of Jesus will not affect you. In 3 days, your body will be totally restored. It will not go no further. I rest it right now in the spirit. Any infection, I curse it. Release the blood of Yahshua upon you. In the name of Jesus, you need rest. You need sleep. Lord, give your daughter a delta sleep tonight. A deep, deep sleep. Visit her tonight, Father. Visit her tonight, Father. Heal. In Jesus' name. Give the Lord a hand, praise. And you be. Tuesday night, I'll be here. Sunday, first Sunday. I want you guys to pack this house out. I don't know what God's going to do first Sunday. We're going to have communion. And something will happen up in this house Sunday. I tell you now, I don't know what it is, but something going to happen in this house Sunday, first Sunday. Because he gave me a vision, it was dreams. And I got to start working towards what he showed me. Amen? So the people here, there will be a tangible blessing for everybody in the spirit. There will be a release in this house. When I fell down on Sunday, there was Jesus up in the pulpit.
Amen.
And his glory is what took me down. So y'all know when I go down to the flow of anointing, the presence is the Holy Spirit. And it was his presence. Those who ordained his prayer, he was in that pulpit. Yeah, he was in that many people. You feel it? Because he came by me, the power came by. I went down, and the power just came by me. So we want to get this house packed, full. I expect Sunday, first Sunday, to be off the chain. Amen. Amen. It says, tell somebody to call, tweet, Twitter, whatever, email, e-blast Sunday. Amen. Tuesday night. Amen. But let's give the women of God another hand praise. Oh my God. I was blessed. I was blessed. I was truly blessed. Amen. Raise your hands up. Get you out of here. May the grace of God and the sweet communion of His Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide hence, now, and forevermore. If we leave from this place, but never from His presence, God, as you go before us to protect us from all hurt, harm, and danger. And I decree by faith that the people of God are blessed going in, blessed coming out, and blessing shall overtake us. In Jesus' name we pray. Hug and tell somebody you love them with the love of the Lord. I hope to see you Tuesday nights with the prophets. And first Sunday, amen. Let's pack this house in Jesus' name, amen.
I just gave you $6.